everybody. This is round one of the October Titanium Challenge here at TJ Collectibles. Thanks for visiting this page. If you're on our channel, either you navigated here on your own, you got linked to it, or I don't know, maybe you just clicked on it. Maybe our algorithms, our searching algorithms, are just great, and YouTube suggested this for you, the Magic Fanatic. Anyway, you got here, thank you for watching. We got a good match set up here for round one. We got Dan Campbell. He's on your left. And we got Kevin Liu. He's on your right. Both of these players, as I was joking to them before the match, kind of the Titanium Series All-Stars, a couple of them anyway, come to most of the events. Top 8 a good amount as well. And in general have a good winning percentage. The one thing that's lacking, though, for both of them, they don't have a win. Neither one of them have a win. And that is all important when it comes to the Titanium Finals. So both searching for a win, both searching for that invite to the finals. Dan Campbell, as usual, has a collected company deck. We'll see what variety he has this week. Retreat to Coralhelm is my guess, as it is the one he's played in the past. We'll find out for you. Kevin Liu, on your right, almost always playing the Valakut, the prime time. He wants to kill his opponent with many, many Valakut activations. He's on 6 cards, is Kevin Liu. Ooh, interesting, Steam Vents. Okay, so maybe he switched to a Bring to Light version. Maybe he has some Blue Hate out of the sideboard. This is still a Sakura Tribe Elder. This is still going to be a Valakut-based deck. Big Daddy Stee, blocks and sacks. Kevin Liu says, eeny, meeny, miny, mo, catch one of your creatures for 1 mana. And in response, of course, the 4 mana instant, the powerhouse of the deck, the thing that makes it all tick. Collected company, finding spell queller. Ooh, that's a nice one. I do believe Lightning Bolt should be exiled under Spell Queller. I'm going to check on that for y'all. There we go. I went to fix that, but they caught it before I did. So Kevin drops Valakut, drops Sakura. He's looking to set up some kind of Bring to Light Scapeshift action, maybe a Bring to Light into Anger of the Gods, some way to wipe this board, because this is getting pretty scary. Sakura finds a forest. And, you know, at the end of the day, Dan Campbell has a lot of creatures on the board, but not a lot of power, right? The most he can attack for is 4 damage. Not even that much. My apologies on the life totals. The iPad that we were going to use was misplaced for this round, but I do believe it's already been found and we'll be ready for round 2. Let's just say Kevin Liu is in the vicinity of about 12 life. Maybe 11, maybe 10. What else? Finds a forest card, finds a Cinderglade. And Kevin Liu creeps closer to 7 lands. 8 lands, actually, he'll need this round. Dan Campbell does not have another collected company. He instead just puts 2 counters on Scavenging Ooze, removing Sakura Tribe Elder. Kevin Liu on what appears to be a 2-turn clock. He needs to either present some defense against Dan Campbell's army, or just straight up kill him. Relic is popped to draw the card. No way Kevin could have sequenced that to prevent the Scavenging Ooze from getting a counter. Mountain count way too low for that Valakut. Even with like a Farseek and a Mountain, still not enough. Prime time though. Oh boy. So let's see. There's one Valakut. There's one Mountain. There's another Mountain. There's another Mountain. I think even prime time founding 2 Mountains won't do it. It depends what that expedition is. I am so bad at knowing what the Zendikar expeditions are. For some reason, my brain just does not work with those Zendikar expeditions. Honestly, it looks the most to me like Eye of Ugin, which it clearly isn't. What is that thing? I don't think it's a Mountain, because otherwise Kevin Liu would have gotten 2 Mountains and gotten 2 Valakut triggers. So he'll set up for next turn. He'll get Stomping Ground. He'll get Valakut, meaning the next prime time swing deals 12 damage wherever he wants, cleans up all the creatures. But here's Mountain for the turn. Two primetime triggers, one at the Spellqueller, one at the Noble, and Dan Campbell shows why he's so good at this deck. He drew another collected company. Like a mastermind. He'll look at the top cards, he'll try and find a knight to set up a potential Coral Helm victory. 2 Voice of Resurgence, not the worst, but definitely far from the best. Kevin also gets to recast his Lightning Bolt. Should point itself at another Noble Hierarch. Kevin Liu resolves prime time and lives to tell the tale. Can he live through this attack phase? I think so. He should be at about 8 life. Dan Campbell would need something pretty special here. Path to Exile might do it. If not for that basic Mountain Kevin Liu would get to fetch. Prime time. Going to block. Blocks a 5/5. Is there a wild size in Dan Campbell's future? Maybe. Nope. Just an activation of the Ooze, going for the trade on primetime, which would normally be pretty good against a fatty deck, which just wants to get out one fatty. But I'll tell you what, those 2 Valakuts on the battlefield, they're not pretty. Another primetime would be pretty good, getting 4 Valakut triggers. Scapeshift, The game-winning Scape Shift would have been pretty good, but goes under Spellqueller. Lightning Bolt into the game-winning Scape Shift. Gonna be pretty good. Kevin Liu gonna sacrifice a bunch of non-Valakut lands. Find a bunch of mountains. Deal approximately 30 damage. The only thing Dan Campbell can hope for here is that Kevin Liu doesn't have enough mountains in his deck. He somehow messes up, sacrifices too many non-mountain lands. But Kevin Liu been piloting Valakut for a long time. I doubt that's going to happen. We'll see. Yeah, that'll do it. So the players go to their sideboards. Dan Campbell, down a game. Kevin Liu has the advantage. Up a game. A pretty good place to be. So of course, what Kevin's going to be looking to do, bring in the sweepers, bring in the Anger of the Gods, bring in the anti-creature measures that Red has such access to. Not much more than that. I mean, it's a linear deck, right? Scape Shift deck, very linear. Just trying to assemble 8 lands and cast Scape Shift. Assemble 6 lands and cast Primetime. Maybe a Through the Breach, depending on if he's playing that, if he's feeling spicy. The last time Kevin had a top 8 was in August, so it was a couple months ago. Didn't manage to top 8 the September one, but did top 8 the August one. That time, he had main deck Anger. And had the same land breakdown. He had the Steam Vents for his Engineered Explosives. He had the Island in the sideboard for the Blood Moon matchup, so he could pay 3 mana for Engineered Explosives and actually have a reasonable chance of beating it. His plan there would be to fetch out the Island early. Drawn to the forest, of which he only has 2, but, you know, Sakura Tribelder, Search for Tomorrow, these allow him to get his basic lands out. So that's his anti-Blood Moon plan. Doesn't really care so much about Chalice, that's also handled by Engineered Explosives. So this Valakut deck, which we often think about as being kind of linear, right? Kind of prone to hate. He set it up pretty well. I like it a lot. His negates in the sideboard, too. He didn't always have that. Back in April, he top 8ed. Came in 3rd. And instead, he was going like anti-burn, back when the metagame was more burn-happy. Was more aggressive deck. He was playing main deck Courser of Kruphix, 3 Obstinate Baloth back then. His decklist has changed. He now has 0 Obstinate Baloth in the 60. A couple on the board. Dan Campbell, he top 8ed back in March, Modern Series, playing the same deck without too many changes. So as we start game 2, Dan going to try and rely a little more heavily on the combo aspect of his deck, the Retreat to Coralhelm and the Knight of the Reliquary. That provides Sam a different way to win. If he had that at any point in that last game, he would have easily won, right? Because the only piece of interaction Kevin had was the single Lightning Bolt, handled pretty easily, really, either by deploying the Knight when it's already at 4-4 or spell quelling. But this starts not too fast. So he must have some nice hate in his hand to deal with this start. Because this does not look like a keepable hand on the surface. No 1-drop, no 2-drop. I'm sure there's a reason that this was not a mulligan. I expect we'll see what it is right here. 4-4 knight's a good start. Just holding up Spellqueller, not the best. So as the Titanium series ramps up through the end of this year and the beginning of next year, of course culminating the 2017 season in the finals, as Knight is played in Search's cast, the North American Challenge, you might have seen some information popping up here and there on social media if you follow Titanium series on Facebook, which I recommend you do. Paul Rietzel's picture has been popping up, Magic Hall of Famer Paul Rietzel. As Knight gets a couple bolts to its face, we see the power of Knight of the Reliquary in this matchup. Must immediately be answered. But the North American Challenge, this is a beloved tournament series from about 10 or 12 years ago. Tom Shea ran it, super successful, had stores as far away as Chicago, Maine, North Carolina, and deep into the Ozarks, holding qualifier tournaments, and the finals was here at TJ's. That's coming back. And I'm pretty excited about it, because I will definitely be trying to form a team to qualify for that tournament. Awesome tournament, invite only, $10,000 prize pool. Details still being hammered out, locations still being determined. And, of course, all the sundry details, the things that don't work themselves out by magic but by hard work through the tournament organizer's part, those are still to come. But there is a reason you've been seeing this kind of thing. So, Spellqueller. Off of Collected Company, grabs a Sakura, and Meddling Mage comes down, names what I have to imagine is Primeval Titan. I'm not positive about that, but that's almost definitely what it was. It wasn't Sakura Tribelder. It could have been Scapeshift, I suppose, but one instant win card costs 6 mana. The other costs effectively 8. You need 8 lands, so I have to imagine it was Prime Time. As Kevin fetches one of those sexy mountains out of his deck. Still fairly unpressured. He's at a high life total. During the draw phase, Dan Campbell Ghost Quarters. Kevin Liu with a bunch of mountains in play. Has to decide what to do. It can't be Primeval Titan. Does he have Farseek for more mountains? Does he have a search for a Velikut somehow? An Hour of Promise, maybe? Ooh, or does he have a Tireless Tracker? That's a spicy one to sideboard in. Dan Campbell with his fourth Collected Company in 2 games. I would play this deck too, if that's how many I drew. So Kevin's like, oh man, that's bad for me. But then Dan has to explain, no, I cast the Coco with the Tireless on the stack to try and find a Spellqueller. It's not actually bounced, it just comes in and does nothing. Interesting, Summoner's Pack during the main phase. Is it another Tireless or is it something else? Kevin lamenting the fact that there's no Flame Tongue Kabu in this format. There is, however, Wood Elves, which will find Cinder Glade, presumably. Oh, no, it's a breeding pool. Interesting. Doesn't want to thin his deck of any more mountains. Wants to secure another green source as a just in case, I suppose. So what else jumps in the way? Pact is paid for. And Kevin is under the gun. His second clue comes out, but will he have time to pop them? The retreat to Coralhelm. That means that any potential blockers are tapped down. Kevin has to come up with ways of interacting with Dan's creatures outside of combat. The Zendikar enchantment doesn't look for much, but it is very powerful. Dan's end of turn fetch could mean a scry, or it could mean a tap. We will see. Kevin, definitely with only one turn to live here, he must find a scape shift, a way to kill Meddling Mage and a prime time. He could find Valakut Triggers, which it looks like he has one here, killing the Meddling Mage. Here is Big Daddy Prime Time. Ooh, countered by Unified Will. Still have to tap six mana for that, though. Dan Campbell with the retreat to Coralhelm trigger available with the fetch land. Tireless Tracker will not block. Kevin Loot needs to find a bolt. Tireless Tracker again will not be able to block. This is an upkeep fetch. Oh, he scries. Okay. Kevin Liu with one turn left. Problem for Dan, though, is any way to fetch a mountain? Means that 3 damage points at Spell Queller. Spell Queller gets back Sakura, which fetches Mountain, and all of a sudden Dan Campbell's board is clear. He got close 2 games in a row, but I think the lack of reach, the lack of hard disruption for these non-basic lands is going to cost him. I mean, look at this prime time. He's going to get a Valakut and a Mountain. 4 clues in play, Wooded Foothills in play. This is not going to end well for him. He'll cut the deck because that is all he has left at this point. The ability to cut the deck. Kevin Liu has amassed himself all of these lands. He has 12 in play, 2 of them being Valakut. He'll play it safe. Dan drawing something like a Become Immense. And even that, I think, would not quite do it. Honestly, he needs a Stonewood Invocation. It's one of the only cards in Magic that would save him here. Some wacky Time Spiral card. Kevin Liu in the catbird seat, looking to move to 1-0 in this 6-round tournament. He's top-8ed 4 titanium events, but has not managed to take home the prize yet. And he'll start strong, he'll start 1-0. Kevin gives him a still had all these, engineered. Players clearly pretty friendly with each other. Players gonna show us their sideboards. Love it when people do that.
Yeah, I kept this little hand on the back of the combo, three lands, and Unifier Will. I was like, oh, this seems like
combo. Dan saying he kept a hand that was slow but manageable. He had the combo, so he had the retreat and the knight. Three lands. So it's understandable. I would have kept that too. I mean, that's his primary plan. He waited till his knight was a 4-4 to deploy it. But Kevin had one of the few ways in his deck to deal with it. He had the two lightning bolts. Side out the voices, side out Anissa, that's spicy. For a counterspell suite, negates, Unified Will, Spell Queller. Which means, actually, that Dan Campbell has main deck Meddling Mage. Curious. Kevin Liu didn't make too many changes. He put in some Relic Progenitus. That's about it. Until then, gonna end this VOD. Move on to round two. For those of y'all who made it through this entire thing, thank you. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think of it. If you hate my voice, if you love Kevin Liu, if you're calling out Dan Campbell for stealing our playmat, leave a comment, like, share, do whatever you got to do. Tag these boys on Facebook. Until then, everybody, until round two, I'll see you in a minute. It's going to be about 30 minutes for me. It's going to be about 4 seconds for you because this playlist will keep rolling. Thanks, y'all.